Well, I guess I'll take the train. And move far away.
Okay, so we're setting our intentions for Paris, and for Paris, the theme is heart. On this trip, I want to fall in love. I don't necessarily mean romantically, although you never know. I will be in Paris for 5 days. You never know who I may meet, but I don't know, I just mean falling in love with life and myself and the city of Paris and travelling. I want to spend my trip feeling so much love in my heart, and I want to leave Paris being more motivated to act through love rather than fear, because I feel like that's something I really want to work on. Whoever I cross paths with, or maybe I'll only be crossing paths with myself, whatever happens, I hope I just feel as much love as possible.
In the city of love, because where else?
Je mange de croissant. Oui, oui, baguette.
Bonjour, bienvenue à my vlog. Je suis très très stressée parce que my Airbnb cancelled on me literally this afternoon. So I'm on my way to Paris in about an hour and I might be homeless. I might be sleeping in the sewers with the ratatouille. No, the Remy. But this trip is starting wonderfully. I'm really excited.
Ew!
Was that some motion? I don't know. Oh yeah, it was. Yeah, so I'm probably not gonna update you properly again until wherever I'm gonna be sleeping tonight. But
La mer qu'on voit danser le long des golfes clairs. A des reflets d'argent, la mer, des reflets changeants sous la pluie. La mer, au ciel d'été, confond.
Hey guys, I'm gonna do a voiceover of this bit because I'm explaining the situation here, but number one, I look really unflattering as you can see, and number two, you can barely hear me because I'm whispering. So basically, I was a bit silly and made a little bit of a rookie mistake and I got off the wrong train station. Like, I knew my stop and I was at the doors at my right stop, but I didn't realize you had to press the button to open the door, like similar to the UK trains. So yeah, I missed my stop. By the time I realized it was too late, so then I had to get off at the next stop and walk to my accommodation, which was about 15 minutes, which wasn't too bad apart from the fact that I did have all my luggage and I was tired, and also it was dark and a bit sketchy. I also saw Remy, which was a lovely start to my trip in Paris, as if things weren't stressful enough with me having to find emergency accommodation. So yeah, that was what was happening. Back to the vlog.
Arrived.
I look like shit. I'm really thirsty.
This is the room.
Very glamorous, as you can see. I'm not happy. I had like a specific like vision for this trip. Like, it's gonna be my own little room in Paris. I'm just so pissed off that the room got cancelled. But I've booked for 2 nights. I'm gonna try and see if I can find another Airbnb for the rest of my time there. I'm not like excited yet because like apart from the little bit I saw like outside of the station, I'm not really seeing Paris and all the wonders of the city of love. So I feel very much like at the moment I'm just gonna go to sleep and then I'll wake up whenever I wake up. I'm so slow, but I'm not rushing. I've been stressed enough, so I'll see you,
Barry. I've spent a lot of time looking out of hotel windows, seeing the trees concave when that Colorado wind blows. I know the metro system inside out. Paris never changes. I know my way about. I said no. When you asked me to dance, as I pulled away, you whispered stay. I was in a trance. I happen to know that what I felt, you felt too. That makes no difference to me. I know this love is doomed, but you dear, I didn't think I'd find you here. Oh, roaming in the corners of my mind, well, in there you'll find a note I wrote the other day. Don't read it, just leave it. It might give me away. Never liked you much, you're always so complacent. And though I laugh along, I find you test my patience. Sure, I have less fun when you are not around. And when I come to think of it, my feet don't touch the ground. But you, dear, I didn't think I'd find you here. Roaming in the corners of my mind, well, find a note that I wrote the other day. Don't read it, just leave it. It might give me away. Why was it you my heart cried for? You were everything I didn't need. Just the book I was told I should read. Standing there with your hat on your sleeve right from the start, competing for my heart. But you, dear, I didn't think I'd find you here. Roaming in the corners of my mind, but then they'll find a note that I wrote the other day. Don't read it,
not me accidentally going the wrong way. Lol. Also, Paris is really giving autumn. Like, this August is really Octobering. I'm on my way to the Arc de Triomphe. Okay with the accent, okay with the French accent. Maybe baguette. I just feel really happy here. I feel just so at peace. I absolutely love the city. Like, just so obsessed. It's just so beautiful. Like, literally every road you turn is just beautiful. Even like the parts that smell like piss. You know, I even saw like a dead rat on the ground. I still love it. I still love it, so.
You are a liar, actress, go the fuck out.
I'm doing another voiceover because I was whispering again and I can't be bothered writing subtitles for what I was saying. So I woke up at 8:30, even though I was meant to wake up at 7, but I kept hitting snooze because I was having a weird dream that I didn't want to wake up from. And also I couldn't sleep because it was really, really hot in my room, so I didn't get to sleep until like 2 or 3 a.m. So I was really tired, but I did feel really bad about the alarm, and hopefully I didn't wake anyone up or disturb anyone. Oopsie, really sorry about that. But yeah, my plans for the morning was to get breakfast because I paid for breakfast included with my room. And then I needed to finish packing and getting ready to check out for 10 o'clock. So I had an hour and a half to do all that.
Sous le ciel de Paris s'envole une chanson. Elle est née d'aujourd'hui dans le cœur d'un garçon. Sous le ciel de Paris marchent les amoureux. Leur bonheur se construit sur un air fait pour eux. Sous le pont de Bercy, un philosophe assis, deux musiciens, quelques badauds, puis des gens par milliers. Sous le pont de Paris, jusqu'au soir vont chanter. L'hymne d'un peuple épris de sa vieille cité. Près de Notre-Dame, parfois couve un drame. Oui, mais à Paname, tout peut s'arranger. Quelques rayons du ciel d'été, l'accordéon d'un marinier, l'espoir fleurit au ciel de Paris. Sous le ciel de Paris coule un fleuve joyeux. Il endort dans la nuit les clochards et les gueux. Sous le ciel de Paris, les oiseaux du bon Dieu viennent du monde entier pour bavarder entre eux. Et le ciel de Paris a son secret pour lui. Depuis 20 siècles, il est épris de notre île Saint-Louis. Quand elle lui sourit, il met son habit bleu. Quand il pleut sur Paris, c'est qu'il est malheureux. Quand il est trop jaloux de ses millions d'amants, il fait gronder sur nous son tonnerre éclatant. Mais le ciel de Paris n'est pas longtemps cruel. Pour se faire pardonner, il offre un arc-en-ciel.
This was literally one of the hardest journeys I've had here, but worth it, baby. Ooh, look at this. So pretty.
this city is way too.
Yes, the application of the Eiffel Tower.
Quand doucement tu te penches en murmurant c'est dimanche, si nous allions en banlieue faire un tour sous le ciel bleu des beaux jours, mille projets nous attirent, mais dans un même sourire nous refaisons le trajet simple et doux de nos premiers rendez-vous. Sur les quais du vieux Paris, le long de la Seine, le bonheur sourit. Sur les quais du vieux Paris, l'amour se promène en cherchant un nid. Vieux bouquini.
My hair looks so bad. It's very late. I'm very tired. I've had a stressful day. Wonderful, but stressful. But you know what? I wouldn't change it because it's all part of the experience. And this is stuff you learn from. You go through the hard stuff and you come out being able to handle yourself more and more so that you could do even more adventurous trips.
Some other thoughts I had on the walk home to my Airbnb was the fact that I felt like when I was watching the Eiffel Tower, I wasn't fully in the moment because I was really stressed trying to make sure that no one would mug me. Lol. That was kind of unfortunate, I guess. Also, I felt like with the Eiffel Tower being the symbol of romance and also the theme of this trip being love, I kept thinking to myself, oh, wouldn't this be a nice moment to share with someone else? Even though, you know, I love spending time on my own and doing things on my own. I don't know, maybe if I was less stressed, I would have been able to focus on enjoying the moment with myself. I don't know.
Je joue contre joue. Je veux jouer, joue contre vous. Mais vous le voulez-vous? De tout cœur, je veux gagner ce cœur à cœur. Vous connaissez mon jeu par cœur, alors défendez-vous sans tricher, je vous le promets. J'ai gagné, tant pis c'est bien fait, vous êtes mon jouet. À présent, ce ne sera plus vous mais toi. Et tu feras ça, t'apprendras n'importe quoi pour moi. Je vais t'assurer un enfer de griffes et de crocs. Tu crieras bientôt au secours. Alors décidant de ton sort, pour m'éviter quelques remords, je t'aimerai plus fort. Oh oui, plus fort. Oui, 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 plus fort. Oh, plus fort. Oui, oui.
I'm not even saying this just because of my whole like manifestation thing, but I love life right now. Like, I'm so happy. I love Paris. I love just life. I made a friend today. She was so lovely. And we went back to the Eiffel Tower. And you know how yesterday I was saying that?
I have no idea what just happened there. I don't know if I saw something or saw someone, so I just suddenly stopped talking. But I was saying that the day before, I was saying how I felt like I could have enjoyed the moment more if I was with someone and sharing that moment with someone. While I do stand by the belief of being able to do things on your own and enjoy things on your own, I must say, going back to the Eiffel Tower at night and experiencing that with such a lovely person was just so amazing. Like, honestly, I just felt so happy, like, frolicking around Paris at night with a new friend, and we got on so well, and I just felt so happy. I think there is a misconception that solo traveling is really lonely, and to be fair, it can be. There are definitely times where it can feel lonely, but you can always make friends while traveling if you want to. Like, I'm really shy, and I'm more so introverted than extroverted, and I have social anxiety, but honestly, I will make friends if I want to. Between hostels or social media or Bumble BFF, which is how I met my friend, like, there are so many ways to make friends when you're traveling. I don't know about when you're in your hometown, because I'm a different person when I'm in London. I don't know how to socialize when I'm in London unless I'm socializing with my sixth form friends. But making friends while traveling is not as hard as you think, I promise you. So I mean, if I can do it, then you can. And if you do and you're lucky enough to meet great people, honestly, the experiences and the memories you make with them will stay with you forever. Learning to enjoy your own company is so important and just amazing, but it is also really nice to share moments with other people as well. So yeah, I don't know, it just it was really nice, really, really nice day. Honestly, one of my favorite days of my time in Paris, for sure.
One of the things I didn't expect to fall in love with, but I'm learning to, is falling in love with unpredictability. I do like being spontaneous, but I do like having a plan. Not everything goes right though, and maybe that's a good thing. Like, literally every single day, something's gone wrong. Like, when I came here, I had to find emergency accommodation. And Sunday, thunderstorm. And Monday, I took care of my luggage around. And then yesterday, I was meant to go to Montmartre. I was meant to go there. And I didn't, because I made a friend and we ended up going elsewhere. Plans are good, but maybe I need to fall in love with the possibility that I won't be able to always follow my plans, and maybe I'll experience different things instead, and I should be open to it. So yeah, this morning I just finished a meeting for work. See, like, I think I've already said I'm working in this one day. I can't afford not to. I'm not doing the full hours, but I'm still working. But I had to wake up at like 9, but I went to bed at like 2 or 3, which is so dumb of me. I could have gone to bed earlier, but I was on my phone.
doing good knows what. I would like nothing more than to go for a nap right now. But I can't do that because I'm going to go to Montmartre. How do you say it?
Montmartre.
Montmartre, okay. I forgot what I was saying. But basically, today, I'll meet my friend that I met yesterday. Before I do that, I want to see the before sunset film locations. And then I'll be meeting my friend in Montmartre. I'm also going to a cemetery, which seems a bit weird, but the cemetery that has like loads of like really famous people. Ed Pla, Oscar Wilde, Jim Morrison. Ooh, there's a mac and cheese place nearby. Cool. Also, I need to make sure I come out early enough today because I want to go to the supermarket. I literally haven't touched the supermarket since I've been here, which is really bad. I'm gonna cook myself dinner and also take food with me for tomorrow. Okay, I'm gonna get dressed. By YouTuber, I literally forgot to give you a room tour, so I'll quickly give you one now, especially since it's my last day today. I'm gonna link below the Airbnb if you do want to stay here. If you're ever in Paris, I would 100% recommend. This is the door, and then mirror that I'm too short for. My bag's in. It's a wardrobe that I haven't used, but probably use it if you want to. Storage space, again, I've not used it, but you can if you want. A cute little bed, it's single, but it's really comfy. Again, more storage here. Here is my favorite part, it's the window. It's like a full length, like door window, balcony thing. It's like a train track, which is so cool. And like, over here you can see it's like, I don't know what this is like, if it's like an office or what it is, but it looks really cool. But you can just see. The heater, which I have not used obviously because it's been boiling, and then table where I've just been putting my shirt, a light and a chair and a book point. And I've been working on my bed because I do that at home as well, but if I wanted to sit down properly and do work then I could. So yeah, that's the room door. Yeah, I'm gonna end up now. I'll show you a quick out of the day.
Are you not embarrassed? This is really embarrassing.
Let me sing you a waltz. Out of nowhere, out of my thoughts. Let me sing you a waltz. About this one night. Dreamt of in life, but now you're gone. You are far gone, all the way to your island of rain. It was for you just a one night thing, but you were much more to me, just so you know. I hear rumors about you, about all the bad things you do. But when we were together alone, you didn't seem like a player at all. I don't care what they say, I know what you meant for me. That day, I just want another try. I just want another night. Even if it doesn't seem quite right, you meant for me much more than anyone I've met before. One single night with you, little Jessie. worth a thousand with anybody. I have no bitterness, my sweet. I'll never forget this one night thing. Even tomorrow in other arms.
I made a friend and we had such a wonderful time together. I'm gonna really miss her, even though I only knew her for 2 days. But she was lovely. I'm just so happy right now. I want life to be as exciting as the past few days have been. Even though it's been stressful, it's still been so much fun. I wanted to feel love on this trip, and I felt like every type of love except for romantic. Which, like, I think is good because I feel like I've truly understood that, like, I don't need romantic love to feel love. Like, even, like, the fact that I've been, like, calling my family, like, nearly every day, like, I genuinely miss them. And even my friend, like, I'll just go off the phone to my friend and the friend I'm with today. And even, like, spend time with myself and, like, enjoying this city. Yeah, I think I definitely achieved what I wanted to achieve. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. The next video will be Amsterdam, which I'll start whenever we got tomorrow. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you're enjoying Intro Diary so far. Au revoir. Bonne nuit. Salut.
On va danser le long des golf clubs.
Type of insanity, you know, there's that shit I don't need. Sometimes I feel like